Hi friends, welcome to another great digital Sunday school lesson. I'm so glad that you're here and that you've been here learning more and more about Jesus. We have another great lesson and we get to learn from Miss Lindy in the library and even have a great worship song that we'll get to sing together in just a little bit. But first, let's start with her Bible verse of the day. And today's verse is Hebrews 13:6. It says, God helps me, I will not be afraid. Can we say that together? 3, 2, 1. Hebrews 13:6. God helps me, I will not be afraid. Today, we're going to learn about a man who was called to be a missionary, someone who shares about Jesus and the good news of what he has done for us by dying on the cross for our sins. And he shared with his whole world, everyone he came in contact with, he made sure they knew that Jesus loved them. You know, let's go ahead and join Miss Lindy in her library and learn more about this man and the things that he did. I'll see you guys after that.
Hello, welcome back to the library. I hope you didn't have to travel very far to get here. Have you ever taken a trip? You might take a short trip to the grocery store, or you might take a long trip to vacation with your family. Many people fly in an airplane when they take a trip. I think flying in an airplane would be fun. Lots of people drive cars on trips. I drove my car to the library today.
Vroom, 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 vroom. Beep, 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 beep.
Some people even travel on boats. They sail up and down along the water. We've talked about three ways people can travel. People can fly in an airplane, ride in a car, or sail on a boat. Which of these ways did people in the Bible travel? Did Bible people fly in airplanes? No, that's silly. There were no airplanes in Bible times. Did Bible people ride in cars? No, they didn't ride in cars. There were no cars in Bible times either. Did Bible people sail on boats? Yes! The Bible tells about people who sailed on boats as they traveled from place to place. Let's hear about Paul and some of the places he visited. Paul and Barnabas were missionaries. Remember, a missionary is someone who goes and tells people about Jesus. Paul and Barnabas traveled to many places and told people everywhere the good news about Jesus. One day, Paul had an idea. Paul said to Barnabas, "Let's go back and visit the brothers and sisters in every town where we have preached the word of the Lord and see how they are doing." Paul wanted to check on the new believers in the cities where he and Barnabas had preached. Paul and Barnabas traveled to different cities. Barnabas took John Mark and they sailed to Cyprus. Paul chose a man named Silas and traveled with him to Syria and Cilicia. Paul and Silas helped the churches there, and then they traveled to other places. While Paul was in Lystra, he met a young man named Timothy. Timothy's family believed in Jesus, and the people who knew Timothy said good things about him. Paul invited Timothy to travel with him. Paul and Timothy traveled from city to city. They visited the churches and taught them about God. The churches grew and grew as more people heard about Jesus. Paul and Timothy traveled to many cities and told more people about Jesus. God helped Paul know that he should travel to Macedonia and tell the people there about Jesus. We immediately set out for Macedonia because God had called us to preach the gospel to them. Paul and Timothy obeyed God and left right away. They knew the people in Macedonia needed to hear about Jesus. Everywhere Paul and Timothy went, they told people about Jesus. God helped them stay safe as they traveled. Paul and Timothy were missionaries. God sent his only son, Jesus, because he cares about us. That is very good news. Everyone needs to know that Jesus is God's son. God helps people tell about Jesus. God helped Paul and Timothy know where to go and kept them safe. God can help you too. God helps you learn about Jesus at home and at church. You can even learn about Jesus while listening to Bible stories at the library. We should be like Paul and tell others what we know about Jesus. Whom can you tell this week? Maybe you can tell your mom, your friend, or your neighbor about Jesus. I think I'll put this toy boat on my desk here at the library. It can remind me how Paul sailed from place to place and told people about Jesus. It can also help me remember to tell people what I know about Jesus too. See you next time!
Welcome back, friends. I'm so glad that you got to listen to that story, and it was so cool to learn about Paul and all the amazing things that he did because he was obedient to what God asked him to do. You know, let's look at our life point for today and learn a little bit more about our story. Today's life point is God helps people tell about Jesus. Let's say that together. 3, 2, 1. God helps people tell about Jesus. You know, Paul was never alone on his journey, on his mission. God was with him the entire way. And the same thing that is true for Paul was true for us. We're never alone when God asks us to do something. He is with us and he will help us to accomplish the mission he gives us. That's some good news. Let's look at our Jesus point today too. Today's Jesus point is everyone needs to know that Jesus is God's son. Let's say that together. 3, 2, 1. Everyone needs to know that Jesus is God's son. Man, that is true. And you know, it's our job to tell people about Jesus. It's our job to be the ones to make sure that everyone knows that Jesus is God's son. Oh, the bell. Oh my gosh, it's already time to worship together. You know, I've had so much fun learning it. Time just flew by. So if you guys will stand to your feet, let's sing and dance and worship Jesus together. Worshiping with you and singing songs to Jesus. You know, our time is almost over, but before we go, I would love for us to review and think about the things we've learned today. Let's start by talking about our memory verse for today. Our verse is Hebrews 13:6. God helps me, I will not be afraid. Let's say that together. 3, 2, 1. Hebrews 13:6. God helps me, I will not be afraid. And then we learned our life point. And our life point today is God helps people tell about Jesus. Let's say that together. 3, 2, 1. God helps people tell about Jesus. You know, in our story, we learn that God helped Paul tell about Jesus to people. He told lots of people about Jesus. But, you know, God doesn't want just Paul to tell people about Jesus. He wants all of us to. Every single one of us is supposed to tell others about who Jesus was, how much he loves us, and what he did for us. So let's talk about our Jesus point, which is everyone needs to know that Jesus is God's son. Let's say that together. 3, 2, 1. Everyone needs to know that Jesus is God's son. And you know, that's true that Paul told people about Jesus, and he understood that everyone needed to know, but that's still true today too. Everyone still needs to know, and it's our job to tell them about who Jesus was and how much he loves them. You know, I've had so much fun learning today with you, and we've learned so much, and it's time to go. I hope you have a great week, and I can't wait to see you again to learn more about Jesus with you. Goodbye, everybody.